Hey gang, Jack Lair here, just with a pickups video. I know it's been a while. I've been kind of on a hiatus, just trying to get everything settled in. Had birthday parties and summer camps and all kinds of other stuff to pay for. Had car repairs to do, which is what brings us. Part of the pickups today is that I got my car fixed and the mechanic said, well, you have to drive it around for 30 minutes at over 35 miles an hour. So I ended up driving around the Dallas-Fort Worth area for about 30 minutes, going to various different places just to kind of stop in and say, hey, well, what's going on in there? I'm going to start out with one game that I picked up and one game that I refound, but I don't know if I ever cover. Now, the first one that I'm going to show you is Dragon Quest Monsters Joker. Now, the thing that you need to keep in mind about this game is that if you look down in the lower right-hand corner, it is a Japanese version. Now, I didn't know this picking it up, but I am slowly using this to learn Japanese. Now, I am by no means an expert, but I do have a nephew who is helping me out, and he is helping me to play through the game. Google Translate is also being very helpful. Now, while I was cleaning behind my desk, I also spied my copy of the Japanese version of Rhythm Heaven. Now, the Rhythm Heaven game, once again, really don't know what's going on here, but I figured out enough to get the game playing. And it's kind of a rhythm game, so you can generally figure out what's going on. It just takes a little bit of time. So those are the two DS games. One I picked up, one I found. I ended up getting the import of Dragon Quest Monsters Joker for 10 bucks. Not too bad. I think the Rhythm Heaven one I picked up for $2.50 in a pickup video ages ago. Now, the other three that I picked up, I'll start with the first one. This was a $1.99. I picked up Vigilante 8 Second Offense. Either way. Racing game? Or not racing game. Demolition Derby type game. There you go. So you can get an idea of it. I remember Vigilante 8, liked it, so I'm willing to give it another shot. Play the second one, see how it goes. By the way, it is still ridiculously hot here in Texas. So for those of you who are wondering why I'm trying to sit very still and at a weird angle. The next three things that I picked up, and kind of the end of the pickups video, it all came from the same place. Now, I go to this thrift store very often, and I stop in usually once a week, just because they do have kind of a high turnover. A lot of it gets picked through, by me, for instance. And sometimes their prices are really good, sometimes their prices are really bad. So, just to give you an idea. Now, a lot of times they'll have old magazines, and I consider old anything PS2, Xbox, GameCube, and back. So anything going back farther than that, I generally pick up. This is a copy of EGM2 for Banjo-Kazooie. It's got a nice little breath of fire there on the back. But these are always 35 cents. So I usually pick them up. They're fun to read through at work when I'm on break and I can't really do anything else. The second game that I picked up, and the case is completely trashed, but I'm gonna replace the front cover of this, and that is Highway Tokyo Battle. I don't know if you're gonna be able to read that. This was $3.93. Pretty standard price for when they start things out there. And then they drop in price every once in a while. They do write in everything, on everything with grease pencil, which bugs the crap out of me sometimes. But this was a nice find, Tokyo Highway Battle. I don't remember ever playing this, but looking at the back, it reminds me of a lot of the Sega Rally and that time frame of racing game, which is actually the time frame that I really like. I miss the boxy 3D racing where you didn't really have wheels, you had like weird octagon things spinning. I miss that stage of racing games. I really loved Sega Rally and a lot of the games. I think Luke Morse has quite a few videos on his channel of a bunch of different Japanese racing games of the type that I'm talking about. So swing on over to his channel and take a look at some of the racing titles that he's shown. And then the last thing gaming related that I got was from the same place, and it just kind of... I don't remember the game, but there's something in the back of my mind that just said, you want to get that. I know you don't remember, but some part of me way in the back did, and that is the Long Box of Warhawk. And I want to say this is the earlier version of the game that failed recently. It did. Starhawk. And it's got the case is actually, it's all dirty and I gotta clean it, but it's actually got the manual in there, it's got the disc in there. The disc is a little, everything's a little, I don't know if you can see, yeah, you can see that. Everything is dusty, so I don't know where it was, but gotta clean it out. They had some other long boxes there, Resident Evil, and I think one of the sports titles that I already have. I don't know, I have a handful of them, but they're just, the long boxes have no appeal to me, just because they're long boxes, I don't really care. I want to play the game. But since most older games, you kind of needed the manual to know what was going on because there was no such thing as a tutorial yet, I want the manual too. So those are the pickups. DS game, Dragon Quest Monsters, Joker. I refound Rhythm Heaven. I picked up Vigilante 8, Second Offensive, Tokyo Highway Battle, Warhawk, and a nice magazine for me to read on break and lunch. And that'll probably last me through a day. I read pretty fast. Anyways, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again real soon. As always, play on!